Who is the most attractive person you've ever seen? That person that keeps appearing in the picture above my bathroom sink. Plot twist, Up has a poster of Danny DeVito above the bathroom sink. There was a girl I knew in high school who was a grade above me. Absolute stunner. Blonde, tall, and unbelievably kind. She always waved at me when she saw me, and one time, I was at a house party. When I went outside for some fresh air, she actually followed me and we ended up alone. Just talking. I seriously wish I had the confidence to shoot my shot at that time. OMG bud, you should have made your move. Every time a girl follows you outside, it's obvious that she likes you. You blew it, dude. But hey, I've done that a few times before too. My ex-wife. Our divorce was on decent terms and we're still fairly close. Not just because she's a beautiful woman, but she's intelligent, well-spoken, very educated, hard-working. And the second she became the mother to our daughter, she was, and will forever be, the most attractive person I've ever seen. I also choose this guy's ex-wife. I'll stick to the other guy's dead wife. I saw this overweight guy at a pool party. 5 minutes later, some girl was drowning in the pool and he jumped in to save her. She wasn't breathing and he gave her CPR. She came back to life. He said, "There you are," and smiled while pushed her hair out of the way. "I don't even swing that way, but take me, bro." My husband. I shit you not. We met in middle school and I had a massive crush on him all the way through high school. A few years after high school, we bonded over a Detroit Red Wings post on Facebook and it was love. Ever since. Years ago, in Philly, I was at a street corner, waiting for the light to change. I looked across to the opposite corner, and that's when I saw her. Don't ask me what she looked like. I couldn't even tell you. But the moment my eyes hit her, it was like a wave of beauty slammed into me with physical force. It rocked me, and I nearly fell over. Right there on the sidewalk, I was dazed, like I was having an out-of-body experience. For a moment, I just stood there, regaining my balance and pulling my mind back onto planet Earth. Finally, I looked back across the street, and she had disappeared into the pedestrian crowd. If it's true that after you die, you can look back at scenes from your life, well, I'd want one more glance at her. Or maybe I wouldn't. Maybe it's best to just leave the magic memories alone. I kinda had the same experience with a girl at a coffee shop in New York. I was on one of those tour buses and we made eye contact. I'm sure she wasn't feeling the same for me, but it felt like we connected there. That guy's dead wife. I also choose that guy's dead wife. Bonnie McMurray. This pharmacist at my CVS. Katie, if you're reading this, you fine. I was walking down the street in Manhattan and saw a model in the middle of a photo shoot. I've never seen anyone more attractive in person. Like, I almost couldn't believe what I was looking at. I saw an actress once at Powell's Books in Portland. The one who plays Bones, Zooey Deschanel. It was so obviously an actress. Like, suddenly everyone else in the room goes dark. I was so awestruck I didn't recognize her at first. And I don't even find her attractive on the show, but in person she was stunning. Edit. Was Emily not Zooey? Greater than the one who plays Bones, Zooey Deschanel. Emily Deschanel plays Bones. She and Zooey are sisters. Some friends of mine and I were walking the trail to a hot spring in the mountains of Colorado. And we passed by this other group of people going the other way. And I locked gaze with a dude who had the greenest eyes I've ever seen. He was gorgeous. We just kind of keep looking at each other until our groups were out of sight. And I've never seen him since. That was, like, 30 years ago. And I've never seen anyone as attractive as him again. Just a glimpse of a guy in the woods. And I've long since moved on with my life. But damn, he was gorgeous. Magneto seems to be the obvious answer here. Michael Fassbender. Ian McKellen. I was in the waiting area of a chain restaurant in suburban Pittsburgh back in the early 1990s. A woman walked in and my brain did a Ctrl-Alt-Delete. The first thought when my brain came back online was, "Hey, whoever that is, she shouldn't be here, and B, I hope she doesn't ask me to kill somebody. Long story short, I later determined that the woman in question had been Ann Perillo, who was filming a vampire movie in Pittsburgh. I'd never seen any of her films before that encounter, so my reaction was independent double-blind verification of what worldwide film fans already knew. Ann Perillo is a smoke show. My old boss, Marcus, he wasn't traditionally attractive, I guess. He was 6'6", thin as a rail. Curly auburn hair. Ivory skin with slight ache scars. Deep blue eyes. His personality was just so alluring. He was always so bright and cheerful and was charming in a dorky way. He got cancer at 19. He assured us that he was fine, but the chemo wasted him to nothing with no response. He passed away a few weeks ago. I'm at a new job now, but it's still hard remembering him before the cancer. He was your boss at 19. What position did he work? Missionary. Danny DeVito. Magnum dong. I got my Magnum condoms and a wad of hundreds. I'm ready to plow. Quote. Margot Robbie. My husband. The first time I saw him, I thought that he was a materialization of my wildest Rhea Masseur. My wife. I advise for no other. She is the most physically, mentally, and emotionally beautiful woman I have ever laid eyes on, and I get to wake up next to her every day. I cherish it. Your wife is lucky. Jennifer Connelly. Can I include my fat cat Bella? Yes. My ex-GF who broke up with me yesterday. Ah shit, dude, I've been there as well. It gets better. This might not be what you want to hear a day after a breakup, but the best thing to remind yourself is that beauty comes from the connection you built too. Once that novelty and feeling wears off, you'll realize she's just like everyone else and you can find someone better. Lupita Nyong'o. Good lord. The girl I used to like. I'm over her, mostly, but she's still attractive to me. Partially agreed. You less than 3. In person, Catherine B. At the Canada Border Services Agency. Absolute smoke show. I was mesmerized. Not gonna say her last name, but those that have met her will know. I'm impressed other people have upvoted in agreement. I'm a teacher and a student's dad came to parent-teacher conferences and I had trouble speaking because he was so attractive. The same thing happened to my coworker when he talked to her. I also went to college with Yaya DaCosta, who was on America's Next Top Model, and she was so striking in person I stopped and stared at her awestruck as she walked by. I'm a straight woman. Actress Ava Green. Bling bling boy. I can't believe no one has said Jason Momoa, that man is a specimen. Natalie Emanuel. My dad. I also choose this guy's dad. I understand. I wanted to work for SDPD and was about to do the physical abilities test when you run the course. Someone from HR for the city and one of recruiting officers run with you and make sure you meet the standards. When I go up to the starting line, he walks up and asks if I'm ready. I'm normally very well spoken, confident, and never speechless. He was so goddamn drop-dead gorgeous. I only giggled in response. Like, what the fuck? That sound never comes out of me. I'm usually into blonde hair, blue eyes. But this tall, tan, dark-haired, handsome, sexy man has me still thinking about Hi, Monsieur. One of the exes was pretty fucking gorgeous too. Reminded me of Brad Pitt in Snatch. The most recent ex was very handsome and sexy too. Had that nerdy vibe about him, but freaky in the bed. I get that giggle feeling. Guy came in for a job interview at the physio I worked for. Light up to get him and nearly swallowed my tongue. Probably the most attractive man physically I've ever seen. Tall, dark, muscular without being over the top. He was so good for business. I saw one middle-aged female patient look up when he called her for her appointment, and she literally looked like she was hit by a brick. She was that shocked by how gorgeous he was. It was literally hard to breathe when he was around. I'll bet he was up for business. I'd be going out of my way to go to your physio too. Lol, I wonder what it's like for the monsieur. Does it get awkward? Was it difficult, distracting to work with such beauty? I failed the test by 1 second too. I'm only being watched, judged, and timed by the most physically beautiful creature I've ever had the pleasure of seeing. Ahaha. It was awkward and very distracting. I also saw him at times for treatment. Top off, and one part of the treatment involved him putting his arms around me in kind of like a bear hug to adjust my shoulder. My man loved those days because he knew he'd get lucky. Haha. Female. Ava Green. Every time I see a pic of her, I feel her eyes are fucking me. They are asterisk so asterisk intense. Now male. Fucking Christopher Maloney. I don't need to elaborate. Alexandra Daddario for me. The name's Randy, but everyone calls me Freak Show. I met a very B-list actress once. At least one role she was in. She was the quintessential plain girl. In a room full of us normal people, she was stunning. Unbelievably good looking. It's spooky how much better looking even B-lister than us mere mortals. There was this one girl in my class during college that was literally dick falling off level of hot. Perfect boobs and ass and an extremely cute face. Leprosy isn't usually considered attractive. We don't kink shame here. Kate Beckinsale, and I'll fight anyone who disagrees. Once I was at the Eaton Center in Toronto and I saw this guy going down an escalator who was so beautiful that time seemed to stop. He looked kinda like Lee Pace's Thranduil from The Hobbit crossed with Peter Facinelli as Carlyle. From Twilight crossed with Henry Cavill as Geralt from The Witcher. He was sporting a loose manbending like 2008. Before it was cool, mainstream. So I couldn't help noticing. And I remember he was wearing this navy scarf indoors even though it was August. And I swear it wafted behind him like there was wind. But that could also be my biased memory. He was that beautiful. It was ethereal. Most attractive person I've seen not in person would be the model Anakye. IDK what it is about her. Maybe the eyes. But her facial structure is just perfect. I met this girl in Japan at a house party. Her boyfriend introduced her. I literally had to fight myself from staring at her. The guy noticed and said something like, "I know. I can't believe she's with me." The girl was trying to be goofy and joke, but like the sheer power of her attractiveness was impossibly distracting. I think they were getting married and the guy was a super nice dude, so hopefully they're happy lol. But fuck. I've never been so thrown off in my life. That answer changes daily. My boyfriend. He looks like off-brand PewDiePie mixed with Simon Pegg. But I absolutely find every bit of him attractive, from his Neanderthal forehead to his Neanderthal actions. He doesn't understand that I wouldn't trade him for the world. But I'm okay with that. I was on the London Underground once and saw this tall and slim girl with the most beautiful face I have ever seen. Everything about it was perfect and I just wanted to look to admire her beauty. And she had no makeup. I didn't stare as I didn't want to seem like a freak and didn't want her to feel awkward as she was completely bald. P.S. Not into bald or anything. It's just her face was so beautiful. Bald is a sexy look. Also, she probably did have makeup on. Sometimes it's just hard for guys to notice when the makeup is supposed to look natural. I only mention this because I wish more people realized it. I saw Jane Fonda and Helen Mirren in person and it was one of those "wow, I understand how you've been so popular in so many decades." Just an air around them. Sue Yu from Twice. A girl named Heba. We dated briefly before your family forbade her from seeing me since I am not Chaldean. I only kissed her twice. She just stopped talking to me one day. I am sure it was against her wishes. I never saw her again. Jake Gyllenhaal. I was at a University of Texas football game with my mom around 2005 and my mom left the stands to run to the restroom as sure she turned into the corridor to get to the back of the stadium and I shit you not walk right into Jake Gyllenhaal. The way she explained it was like slow motion where they were face to face within inches and he looked right into her eyes. Totally took her breath away. Said he was absolutely gorgeous. Ooh, I wish I could have an experience like that XD. Chances are, I'll never meet a celebrity in my life. Though, if I do, it would probably be someone I don't recognize, lol. And yes, Jake Gyllenhaal is very gorgeous. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.